Where we lived was at Pearl City Peninsula, which is a finger like that goes down right into Pearl Harbor. Okay, the peninsula does. So we actually lived about three or four blocks from Pearl Harbor for the shoreline. It was actually about three or four blocks, and probably three blocks to our left and three blocks to the right. So it was a small peninsula area, but you were right in Pearl Harbor. It's not like we were, a distance 5 miles away or something. First thing I remember, of course, is when we were still in bed, and all of a sudden we heard the rumbling and explosion that sounded like thunder or something, but the house was shaking, and so my mom was up making breakfast, pancakes for breakfast. We're going to have pancakes and then go to church. But all of us boys were awake, but we were just in the bed and hadn't gotten up and gotten out of bed yet. My dad hadn't gotten out of bed. And when the house started shaking and big explosions, well, it scared everybody half to death. So you jumped up. The first thing you do is run outside and see what's going on. So everybody's out there, your neighbors. And as we ran out there, the first thing I remember, and this is the part I never forget, is this Japanese plane coming over about, couldn't have been over 50 feet in the air, just coming right over the house. And the pilot looking down at us with his goggles and his little helmet, and that big red ball on the wing must have been, I said, I don't know about this, 2-3 feet across. I swear, if I had a baseball or a rock, you could have hit him. My dad was working in Pearl Harbor as a rigger. He's an ex-Navy man, 6 years in the Navy. Had been away from, he's originally from Westville, Illinois. But after Navy, he stayed in Hawaii after getting discharged after 6 years and married my mom, who is from the Big Island, Hawaii. Anyway, he worked at Pearl Harbor at the time of the attack. Well, he got up and he came out with the neighbors, and we were all looking to see what's going on. And he says, must be maneuvers. So he says, let's go down to the shore and watch the maneuvers. So we did. We got in the car and we drove down. It's only about four blocks to the shore. And I remember standing in the between my mom and dad, looking through. I was in the back seat, and there was a ship out there, and two planes dove on it, and they let loose with bombs, and the first bomb missed, and you seen the splash like you seen in the movies where the water spout, and then the second one hit the bomb hit the ship and exploded. So Dad says, this ain't no maneuvers. So we turned around, and we were still in pajamas. He finally turned on the radio, and the radio was saying, this is no drill. The Japanese are attacking Pearl Harbor. And so I don't know, the men got together and decided to evacuate us, which was the smartest thing they ever did. But we had to change clothes. We get out of our pajamas and stuff, and gather what clothes we could a little bit. And the man says, okay. He had a bunch of buddies that worked with him, and they got together and decided to evacuate us out of the area, because the planes were coming right over you. And by that time, you've started to get some ack from the ships and stuff firing back at the planes and stuff. The men took us up the road, the main road that went all the way up to Pearl City, and it continued on up to a mountain, a gradual climb up to the foothills of the mountain, actually. And we went up there, and That way we were, now we were a couple miles where we could just look down on the harbor and watch the whole thing from up in there. As we watch it, you know, planes, a stray plane or something, would come by, and we'd run back. There was, up in the mountain, there was irrigation ditches alongside of the mountain, and it had tunnels in parts of it where the irrigation ditch would run through the mountain. They'd cut through it. So we'd run up there, and whenever a plane came, we'd run in that ditch, which was about 3-4 feet deep, and run into the tunnels. In the back into the tunnels and hide. And we had one plane one time strafed above, but it was high. And a bomb went off, but I never did see where, the noise scared you. You had stray bullets, like when the planes weren't there, we would go back out to the road and watch the whole burning. The ships are burning, of course. The same pictures you see in the movies where the ships are burning like crazy out there. And so forth, but we're watching that, and a stray bullet, one of my brothers was sitting under the tree, there was a tree up there, and a stray bullet, twing, you know, went off the road. And our house had bullets, oh, must have had about a dozen bullets, stray bullets, hit, and shrapnel, and that's why I say it was smarter than men to get us out of there. Especially with the shrapnel. I had a big box of shrapnel I gathered up as a kid. You know, you go around looking for the bullets in the shrapnel, right? And I had a big box of shrapnel. I like a bomb head I found, or the shell head, I guess it was. I don't know, with numbers and things. I seen President Roosevelt there one time. He came. He came down by, and he drove by, and right by the house, he went to this rich guy's. One rich guy had a place down there, but it's, President Roosevelt came by with that car, with the flags on the front, you know, and the motorcycle escorts and the sirens. I remember standing alongside the road watching. We did move from where we were on December 7th to another house, closer to the shore, before we left, and then they built army barracks right across the street. And put up those machine gun nests and balloons. Those balloons with the cables hanging down in case you had another attack in the harbor. And we had built an air raid shelter in the backyard by digging a trench. You dig a L-shaped trench, about 4 feet deep, and then you put some beams across it and put the dirt that you dug it up on top. And that was your air raid shelter. But because we did have some air raids every once in a while, and I don't know, you know, they were false alarms, but I remember all your houses all the windows had to be covered. You know, you couldn't have light, you couldn't smoke a cigarette even when an air raid. And my dad was an air raid warden. He became an air raid warden too. But and you all got issued. Then you had to go get gas mask and all of those things up at Pearl City. They had to, you go through a gas chamber and check it out so it don't leak and so forth. But you know, you went through all of that. I think that's one of the biggest worry was that because of the First World War, the gas dangers using gas.